There she is. Don't curb the wheels. Don't curb the wheels. Good morning, guys. Welcome back to another video. Of course, the sun is right in my eyes. But anyway, guys, welcome back. Hopefully, you guys had a great weekend getting some stuff done. Monday morning, first official real chilly day of the year. It looked like across the country today was going to be one of the coldest days that we've had thus far this year. So anyway, meanwhile, shameless plug, all of the new winter fall wrenchwork stuff is coming tentatively in about a week. I'm hoping that we are going to launch the second toolbox giveaway this upcoming following Monday. So make sure you guys stay tuned for that. I'll keep you guys updated. Anyway, in recent news here, just to kind of catch you guys up, my parents were here for a couple days. Allie actually went home with them, and then she's flying back. Not really important, but we have to go pick her up from the airport, which is kind of pertaining to the second part of my little talk here. Anyway, me and my dad spent a little bit of time on the Peterbilt polishing this thing out. Take a look. Actually, you know what? Before, don't look at that. Don't look at that. Look over here so you guys can remember how dull these things were. I don't think they have been touched in quite some time, especially the rear wheels. Really just, they really need some love. Now, me and my dad, we got some Renegade Rebel Red polish. I've never tried this stuff before. I've always been a little leery on polished wheels, especially on the pickup trucks, because I don't like cleaning them. I find it kind of time consuming and hard. So these wheels, my dad was like, hey, let's try it out. My dad loves detail. And if anyone has ever seen my dad at any of the events, that's what he does. He loves going over the trucks. That's what he really, really loves. He started using Renegade when I started using them, and he has loved them. Now, he's been using this polish, and he's like, man, let me tell you, 10 or 15 minutes a wheel, we will have these things looking a million times better. This was no machine, just by hand. I was blown away. Absolutely blown away. This is what we used. I've had one of these sitting around in one of my kits that I got. Take a look at the rear wheels. Like, let me back up here. Just absolutely, for 10 to 15 minutes a wheel, like, we had a little bit of time in between some of the stuff that we were doing this weekend, and he was like, let's just go out there, hit him. I didn't even really want to do it, but he was like, I'm telling you. So anyway, if you guys want any of that stuff, you guys always know Renegade discount code is down below, or you can use it at any time. We'll save you some bucks, but yeah, so we did that this weekend. Now, moving on to today's video real quick, we're actually going to jump off the Peterbilt because I'd much rather work inside today, seeing that it is a little chilly. We are going to jump on Allie's truck. Like I said, she is gone for a day. I really would love to finish the truck up for her. That way, when she comes home, and we actually have to pick her up from the airport today, it'd be cool to pick her up in the airport in her truck. She's not really expecting us to work on this. We've been working on the Peterbilt. So we are going to jump on Allie's truck today. Maybe even be able to pick her up from the airport, but we do have a little bit of a list to do. Now, we finally have our back-ordered intercooler boots from Banks. We've got her pipes powder-coated. We actually got them powder-coated. I can't tell if you guys can see this, but this is like a bronze chrome color. It's actually got some sparkle, some flake in there. The sun is kind of a little messing it up here, but super nice color. We've got the Banks Monster Ram intake horn that's in the shop. We're gonna be putting that on as well. So we've got everything engine-wise to complete that. The only thing that we are going to mess with a little bit too is we are going to download this software called Alpha OBD2. Now, if you guys are a Chrysler Mopar fanatic, you may have heard of that. It basically unlocks a lot of certain things inside the computer. We'll go over it, but I'm thinking that it's going to help us with our ABS. Basically, I think what we need to do after researching and a lot of you guys reaching out to us, I think we need to do an ABS initialization on this truck. It's got some stored ABS codes from when the ECM was bad, and I think that that will solve our problem. So, lots of little stuff. We still need to secure the bumper, the fog lights, that kind of stuff. So we are going to fire this beast up. 30 degrees, a little bit of a cold start. So we're gonna cold start this girl and pull her in the shop. Stay warm today. Obviously the heat's on in the shop. And then tomorrow and the next couple days, we will be jumping back on the Peterbilt. It's supposed to, oh, don't see that. No, don't see that. Good morning, Michael.
It's Antarctica outside.
Say it again.
Antarctica outside.
If there's one thing that Michael dislikes in this world, it is cold weather. I'm in a sweatshirt. He needs to have a parka on. Thing sounds like it's getting ready for takeoff. Quick, shut the door. Letting all the heat out. All right, one last look before we get started diving in. Here are all the boots, the clamps, intercooler pipes. We got the Banks Monster Ram intake horn. What we're gonna do is we're gonna spend a little bit of time before this goes on, kind of shaving the letters down, getting them polished up. That way you can see the Banks. Oh my goodness, what is, I didn't realize what was happening. I was like, what are all those noises? Whew, scared me. So we're gonna polish down the Banks Monster Ram letters. Obviously you guys know Banks everything. What are you doing over there? You're scaring me. We're gonna take the Banks intake off. If you guys have ever put intercooler pipes on a fourth gen, they are definitely not the most fun thing to do in the world, especially because Banks moves everything to the big diameter pipes. No kinks, no nothing. It's a little difficult to squeeze down in there, but I think, what do we got going on over here, Michael? Are we ready to plug this thing in right now?
Yeah, we're plugged in.
Oh boy, we are plugged in. So we have spent a little bit of time this morning doing some Alpha OBD2 things. We're just trying to get familiarized. If you guys don't know, Alpha OBD2, I don't even know how to technically, how would you classify that? Software, hardware, for Dodge Ram, especially for trucks, that allows you to unlock a lot of things that the factory guys probably don't even know that they can do. You can move tire thresholds. We are going to try to do an ABS initialization, trying to get that word out. But you can make your corner lights blink. I'm just scratching the surface on what you can do with this stuff. Basically, if you have like a, but what we're gonna use it for is like, we have a base model truck. We're gonna try and incorporate some of the layer me features of what we can. Today, we're really just trying to get that light off the dash. But Alpha OBD2 is just an online thing you can purchase. You need a wireless little OBD2 reader. Michael's gonna try and mess with that while I'm doing the intercooler pipes. And hopefully we can tag team this thing. And we can be driving this thing today and get some of the first couple miles on it, make sure that we are good to go. Enhance. I don't know what movie that's from. You know what I just realized? Look at the sweatshirt that you got on. Bro, I got my Rustic Nail sweatshirt, I got my Rustic Nail t-shirt on.
Yeah.
We're Rustic Nailed out today. Friends, quick update before we keep chugging along. Obviously, can never get away from a bloody knuckle here. But the passenger side off the turbo is all done. I think they actually redesigned this pipe from when I first got them on my dually, because insulation was quite a bit better, actually. Not any time at all, but got that connected to the intercooler down there, got it connected to the turbo. Gonna go ahead and pop the Banks intake back on. I forgot that we also got a new filter element, because ours was pretty worn out, pretty dirty. We tried to clean it up the best we can, but we got a new one. Gonna go back in the Banks cold air intake box and take a look at the monster ram that Michael shined up. Oh my goodness. Looking like so good. So we got our polished up. We actually used the same Renegade product stuff that that we used on the Peterbilt. We shined it up quite a bit. Michael, how many steps did you do?
Steps.
Grits.
Four.
Four
and then polish.
Four and then polish? What are the steps? Polish. Woo!
Probably need another one, but
she's good. All right, so we're gonna throw the intake back on, throw the driver side stuff back on. Michael's trying to get an ancient computer to work that doesn't have Bluetooth, so we might need to rethink ourselves right there. But I'm gonna go ahead and wrap up the engine side completely. That way, all we have to do is mess with that, and we should be able to get this thing on the road. We're moving along. We're moving along good. Trying to do a little less talky, a little more worky. Hey, you're dropping stuff all over the place there, Jimmy.
Where? What?
What?
What am I? What?
Oh.
Yeah, that's what you get.
Hold on a second. Hold on.
No, it's good. I'm not waiting for you. I'm sending her right in. I'm sending her. Whoa, 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 whoa! You got power tools again, Dale.
You're
on your sweatshirt. Oh.
You are.
Oh, I know. Kyle's gonna watch this. Kyle, look at what he just did to your sweatshirt. He put. Michael's using power tools again. Holy crap. Give me back my intake horn. Guys, we're. Oh. Here he goes again with the compressor. Now I got metal shavings in my intake manifold. Wait till I blow the welds on the intake manifold. Excuse me, sir. Sir. Oh, look at that engagement. Oh, yeah. That's beautiful, Michael. No boost leaks here. Bop.
Okay. Kyle's gonna kill me.
He is gonna kill you. I'm putting it in there too. I'm not taking that out. Next!
Bro, now I'm all flustered.
Oh no! Well, I'm not the one who wiped it on my sweatshirt.
Well,
on purpose.
I forgot I had this one on. I thought I had a Wrenchworks one on.
Oh! With the jokes again. Are you sleeping underneath there or what?
I was trying to keep talking.
All right, guys, we got one thing left to do, and that is just tighten up the front bumper. Went ahead and got new fog light hardware. If you guys remember, I was just holding that stuff up with zip ties. Got the correct clips and hardware. Went ahead and put in this trim piece right here on the top of the intercooler that I forgot. Luckily, I was able to squeeze my hands in there. So got this little trim piece, makes it a little bit nicer in between, I don't know if this is the condenser or whatever, right between that and the intercooler. And we are done with the piping and the boots. Would you just look at that? So got the intake horn on, monster ram, and Can't really see a whole lot down there, but got the other intercooler pipe done, and all those clamps are tight. So, again, we're just kind of just checking over some nuts and bolts down there just because we're about to hit the road. We're going to adjust the bumper, and we are going to... what are you doing underneath there? We're going to start driving. You scratching something?
Yeah, exhaust stickers.
Oh, stickers. Hmm. All right, no stickers. Gotcha. Okay. All right, so going to tighten up the bumper. Going to hit the road. Also, we have deemed that the computer that we were using over here that should have been good does not have Bluetooth. So we need to go get a computer to Bluetooth. So I think our first test drive is actually going to be to Best Buy because I have needed a new laptop for all of the EFI Live trucks, tuning trucks. We need a new computer just to kind of keep in the shop here. That way we can order parts, just keep it in here. Because, you know, tuning and some of this OBD, Alpha OBD2 stuff doesn't work with Mac. And I use Mac for everything, but it doesn't really work on some of this computer stuff for the truck. So probably just have to bite the bullet and buy a Windows-based computer. But, okay. Hey, you ready to adjust this bumper, Jimmy? I'm joking, of course. I'm joking. This is all a joke. This is the first time this thing has driven since 2015 on the road. Does that blow your mind a little bit?
Does
this a little bit?
I feel bad stepping on the carpet.
All right, so we still got our ABS light on, and we still have our tire pressure deal. But other than that, I mean, I think we're good.
Certainly not real fast.
Just taking her easy, okay? We're taking her easy. Nice and slow. Letting that trans relearn happen, you know what I mean? It's the first time this trans has shifted in 5 years. Give it some break, okay? All right? First fuel fill up in 5 years. This thing's like, what's happening? Somebody's using me? Hey, our light went out. ABS light went out. Yes! ABS light went out! Woohoo! All we gotta do is tire pressure now. High five! Yes!
I mean, before too long, we won't have to go to Best Buy.
I mean, we don't need to go to Best Buy. I mean, we're gonna go to Best Buy eventually, but we don't need to, like, go rush there right now.
Yeah.
Well, we do for the tire pressure thing.
Yeah.
I'm so happy. I'm so happy. If anybody else hates lights on their dash, shameless plug, hit the thumbs up button. Because lights on the dash to me, there's nothing worse. Nothing worse.
Okay, just one moment. Let me get to that screen. Is it a credit card you said?
Yeah, it's a Visa.
What did you do?
Cut the tape.
Oh my goodness. What are you doing? This is how accidents happen.
I'm not driving.
All right, guys. Well, we had to stop and get some celebratory monsters because this is such a good day. I mean, you know what they say. It's my birthday. All right, so we are still driving this thing around a little bit. We are going to take it on the highway. First, you know, there's a first for everything. First time on the highway in 5 years for this,
right? Probably like 47. You've had lots of birthdays lately.
You know, they go backwards. They don't go forwards in my case. So we went to Best Buy. We got a new laptop.
I'm Cortana, and I'm here to help.
Listen here, Cortana.
A little sign in here, a touch of Wi-Fi there, and we'll have your PC ready for all you plan to do.
She's awful bossy.
Use your voice or the keyboard along the way, and if you'd like me to stay quiet, just select the little microphone icon towards the bottom of your screen.
Quiet.
If you need an assistive screen reader, press the Windows, Control, and...
All right, guys, but seriously, the truck is doing awesome. I am so pumped right now. We put insurance on it. We went ahead, we went to DMV, seeing that Allie's flight got delayed, we were able to take care of all of that. So we're just kind of cruising around, just putting some miles on her, getting the trans relearn done. We are up to 83 miles. I think it's time to trade in soon. She's getting kind of old. Check it out, guys. Almost 100 miles on her. 96 miles, man. So pumped. I came home, I immediately was like, oh, you know what, we got to put some tire shine on it. It really needs a good bath. Another first in 5 years, first bath in 5 years. But truck is running and driving, no lights, everything is working good. Just trying to get a couple good easy miles on it. No pulls, no nothing, just a couple easy miles for the transmission to relearn itself. Kind of make sure everything is good before we start doing anything. But man, oh man, finally get to drive the beast. Oh yeah, super excited for Allie to start using it, for me to steal it from her all the time. Now we can finally start playing with a little bit. Now that I know everything is solid, everything is good, we can start having a little bit of fun with it. But definitely going to drive it as is for the time being. Probably going to put some fuel additive in it, seeing that it has not had any of that. We got, ooh, yeah, it's a little rubbish on these tire setup. That'll be one of the first things that we're going to change. We're going to probably put some Thurin springs on this thing, raise it up just a little bit, lower the back a little bit. It is sitting so raked out right now. I don't know if you'll be able to see this on camera, but the back end is super high on this thing. But anyway, boys, pretty much going to load up and go pick up Allie. All right, here we are, Nashville International Airport. We are gonna surprise Allie with her new truck. I guarantee you she's going to be in shock because she's going to not believe that I am capable of calling the insurance company and putting insurance on this vehicle, but joke's on her. She gets to drive home. Oh, I'm pumped. She's going to be like, what in the world? Don't curb the wheels. Don't curb the wheels. Oh, hit the unlock button.
What are you doing?
Hey, babe. Look at what I'm driving.
I see that.
You're driving home, too.
Okay. I can't get that bag in the back.
I'm really driving. Heck yeah, you're driving. She thought I was joking. I missed you. It's been so long. How you doing?
Good. I literally can't even know how to lift that.
What?
One-handed?
One-handed. We're going in.
That bag is full of secrets.
Get in there, girl. What? Allie's over here thinking people are gonna get yelled at. We're fine. Hop in there. You might need to move the seat up. Okay. Babe, we got your truck done. Look, there's no lights on the dash, minus for the tires.
minus one
for the tires.
Oh boy, watch out, curbs.
Easy, easy on the curbs. Don't jinx
you
it.
You got close.
It, I know. Well.
Turning radius, right?
Yes, you have full turning radius. You can use it to your advantage.
Okay, cool.
I need to put my seatbelt on. With you driving.
For real?
Don't worry, it doesn't have a pedal monster yet. It's not a beast. We're still breaking in the transmission,
We're still babying it.
Careful over here, careful.
Oh
careful.
My gosh, what do you want me to do? These are tight curves.
Grocery getter, here we go. Well, easy on the throttle pedal.
Okay.
We're breaking in the transmission.
The Subaru's trying to creep up my...
That's okay. They can wait.
Do you know which way I'm going?
No, I have no idea where we're going. She shifts a little firm right now.
That's
right. I feel like you're giving her more throttle than I have been the whole day.
I'm going 40 miles an hour.
You don't want to go over a certain throttle percentage. It's gotta be easy on her.
Good Lord.
Oh man.
I think you should be doing directions.
Alright, directions. Left, 250 feet. You're doing great. We will catch back up after our hour drive home from the airport. But Allie drove back home and then flew back less than 24 hours because in that suitcase has all of the new WrenchWorks stuff that we'll be dropping hopefully within a week, which I believe I shamelessly plugged in the beginning of this video. So stay tuned for some sneak peeks. We finally got all of the samples. Everything's done being printed, right? So, I mean, everything's ready, set to go. We're literally just waiting on the toolbox to show up any day now. Got all the tools to put in it, but it's a little bit of a custom toolbox that we got for this drop, so we're waiting for that to come in. Should be like any day now, so hopefully within a week, guys. Stay patient. I know a lot of you guys have been wanting all of the winter stuff. Obviously, it's 50 degrees here. It's probably already colder back home. How's it first merge on the highway?
Yes.
Ooh, baby. I'm driving this thing more than she is. I already love this thing. But anyway, stay tuned. We'll update you guys when we get home on Allie's first experience driving. I'll do some maps for her, but I need to edit this video because this is going up tonight. So I'm actually going to start editing it right now. Was she? We made it home. One piece.
That was awesome.
How'd it feel?
Good.
She feels smooth?
Heck yeah. It was awesome.
These freaking dogs. Look, dogs are excited to see mom. You've been gone for less than 24 hours. Ay. All right, babe. So you love your new truck?
Love it. Nice.
She felt good?
Steal it.
Oh, I'm stealing it. All right, close out the video. It's all you.